In this video, we're going to provide a general overview of the PySQL Data Access Server Real-Time Query Processing, or PySQL DAS RTQP, query engine and schema. Let's begin by opening SQL Commander. In this video, we're going to focus on the New Green database, which is an example database provided by OSIsoft for training purposes. Let's begin by opening the query compendium for the PySQL client. In the queries folder, we see tutorial.sql, and we also see datamodel.jpg. Datamodel.jpg is a flowchart that describes the schema in great detail and how all the different tables are related. I encourage you to pause the video now and look through this as much as you would like. Now let's look at the tutorial. The tutorial SQL file contains queries that are run against the New Green database. The New Green database is an AF database provided by OSIsoft for training purposes. If your development server does not already have the New Green database, I recommend importing it now. Before we can begin, we need to create a connection to the New Green database. Let's right-click on PySQL Client and Connect. Type in the name of the AF server and the name of the AF database. Now let's set the connection of this query window to the newly created RTQP connection. And let's run the first query. Here we see a list of all 16 elements that are based on the Boiler template across the entire AF database. If you recall from the PyOLDB Enterprise query schema, the template name is not included in the element table. The element table simply included the element template ID, and the element template table, which contained the name of the template, would need to be joined in order to add the where clause for the template name. While PyOLDB Enterprise's schema is normalized, the RTQP schema is not. This makes for simpler queries and fewer joins. Let's look at some other queries that are contained in this tutorial. For example, this query returns sampled values for all attributes on this element. As you can see, we have hourly values for each of the attributes on this element. What I want to point out in specific is that the attribute table itself contains the information for the element name. This also is not the case with PyOLDB Enterprise. In order for the attribute values to be returned with the element name as a filter, multiple joins had to exist. In this data model, simply the attribute table needs to be cross-applied with the getSampleValue table value function. Let's expand the master schema and take a look at some of the other items. As I mentioned before, the RTQP schema is denormalized, so when we expand out the tables and table value functions, we see substantially fewer than we did in PyOLDB Enterprise. Each of the tables can be expanded to see the columns list to see which items are contained within the table. I encourage you to go through the rest of the tutorial file and play around with the different tables in the master schema. For now, let's move on to creating a custom database object. In PyOLDB Enterprise, this was constrained to views and transpose table value functions. The RTQP query engine has a much larger range of customization. Let's right-click on catalogs and create template-specific data model. Let's give our custom catalog a name and create a new schema for the equipment. In this schema, we'll put things like boilers, heaters, compressors, etc. We'll start with the boiler template. Here we have the option to create different types of database objects. So let's begin with a view. We'll add the attributes we're interested in to the right side of the view. We'll keep the timestamp, unit of measure, and error, although those are optional columns. We'll click OK. We'll repeat the process for getSampleValue, as well as getSummaries. We'll click Next. And before moving on, let's copy what we see here in the screen into a notepad file. This file contains the query execution for creating all of these functions and views. We'll click Next and execute. Let's execute our view to see all the different values that we were interested in for the boiler template. We see that the view we created is automatically in the transpose format. It also provides the units of measure as well as the values. Now, let's filter this down to just the fuel gas flow and execute the query. Now, let's explore the template folder within the master catalog. Here we see value. Let's right-click on this template, script, create view, new query window. Let's give the view a name and put it into our newly created catalog, as well as our equipment schema. Let's name it boiler liters per second. Let's change the template to boiler. And let's return to the notepad file to make sure that we get the rest of the items correct. We're interested in the fuel gas flow, so let's grab those items. Let's change the desired UOM to liters per second. And let's remove the rest of the items, since this is the only attribute we're interested in at the moment. Let's execute the query to create the view. Now let's refresh our views in the equipment schema and execute the liters per second version. Let's change the select statement to match the select output of the other query. Now let's compare the results to the previous query. Here we see a value of 99.8 feet cubed per second, and here we see 2827 for liters per second. As we look through the notepad file, we see that not only was the view created like this, but also all the functions. I encourage you to use the wizard to generate an output file such as this, and then use the templates folder to try to make some on your own. If you would like to use the template in this folder, however, you did not save the output from the notepad file, and you would like to look at an example before continuing, simply right-click on any of your existing views, go to Scripts, Create View, New Query Window. This gives you the definition of the view, and is exactly what we saw in the notepad file. For example, we could use this technique to create a new view for the heater template. Let's do that now. We'll look at the heater template and see what attributes it has. It has asset name, fuel gas flow, and process, but no process feed rate or water flow. Let's change the template on this script to heater and remove the last two items. We'll change the name to heater and we'll execute the creation. Great. Now let's refresh the views and execute the heater view. We see that we have all of our heaters based on the heater template, and we have the asset name, the fuel gas flow, and the process name. If we later decide we want to add another attribute, let's say model, we can do that easily by right-clicking on heater, going to scripts, alter view, new query window. We'll copy what we have here and change it to manufacturer. And execute the query. Now let's refresh our view. Here we see that in addition to the asset name, fuel gas flow, and process name, we now have the manufacturer name. We can further customize the schema by right-clicking on the schema name, going to scripts, and create either view, function, or function table, which provides you with a header to start your creation of your own function. Further, at the catalog level, there's also a script to create a new schema. Let's do that now. And let's refresh the catalog. I'm going to further build out the schema according to the new green database. Now I'll refresh my catalog and show all the different views that I was able to create in my custom schema. The highly customizable schema of the RTQP query engine should hopefully result in better logical organization of database objects for those who are using them and building the PySQL queries. This concludes the video on the general overview of the schema for the PySQL DOS RTQP or PySQL Data Access Server real-time query processor. Thanks for watching.